You are watching how to build a capacitive battery charger. It's extremely simple to build. I started with building just a little wooden frame box. Very convenient to put everything in. You're going to want a timer. I recommend a 12-hour timer. Gives you plenty to charge just about any battery or electric car. And then in the middle there we have a bridge rectifier. For this setup I used a 600 volt 32 amp bridge rectifier. I found they worked fairly well. And of course your AC capacitor. It's a shot of the specifications. This capacitor will give you approximately 2.5 amp charge. And I capped off with heat shrink. I like capping off the terminals I don't need. That way I don't have to worry about anything touching them and shorting. So what you're going to want to do is, I don't have the top board on, so that way it's easier for you to see the components in there. When I'm done, I'm going to put the top board on, put a nice piece of acrylic over on each side, so that way it's completely enclosed, much safer, don't have to worry about anybody sticking their fingers in and getting shocked. But I'll secure your timer, capacitor, and bridge rectifier. I just used, of course, some spare components that I had laying around, a couple clamps I screwed in, capacitor slid right in. And done. Nice and easy, simple. For wiring, but first I'm just going to do a quick walkthrough here for the wiring, and then in the next video you can see under my account, you can see what the completed wiring setup looks like once it's all done. You're going to have your AC incoming. One of these is going to go right to the back to the timer. The other AC line is going to go to one of the commons on the bridge rectifier. You can see right there. Yep, positive. Negative is this side, the opposite of the positive. And then the other two poles are for the common for the AC lines. So I plugged it in one of the utility into one common, and the other utility would go into the timer. Since I'm only doing this one-handed with the camera here, I'm just going to rest that there. Of course, I'm not going to be plugging it in without everything being tightened down. Then you will be going another wire. Be going from the top of the timer, or the output of the timer, into one of the capacitor lines. And last, you then go from the unused capacitor line to the other common on the bridge rectifier. And just pretend these other two here are nice and secured into the timer. So look at the markings on your rectifier. Like I said before, we got positive here, got negative back here. You would then take your leads going to your battery clamps, plug in your positive and your battery and your negative battery. And then I've got to grab some alligator clamps yet, but Then you got your positive and negative. You would then clamp these onto the positive and negative terminal on your battery. Once you do that, only after it's connected to your battery do you plug it in and turn it on to the desired amount of charge time.